What is going on, guys? Adil Kimbos here, and I'm very excited to play Assassin's Creed Syndicate. Now, this game came out last week, October 23rd. Today is October 30th, the day before Halloween, well, the night before Halloween, Friday night, and I, to be honest, this game didn't look all that amazing from when I watched the trailers, but I'm hoping to be surprised and wowed and all that, so let's get into it. If you guys like it, please leave a like, comment, rate, subscribe. If you didn't like it, that's fine, just let me know what I could do or if it's, or what you didn't like about it. So finally, let's get into Assassin's Creed Syndicate after the options menu. JFK.
The past is your playground, Abstergo. Hello, initiate. Recently, Abstergo Historical Research began several new projects in London. We both know that when Abstergo makes big moves, the Templars are up to something. We think they're hot on the trail of a new piece of Eden. I've got people in London looking for it.
Hey, Bishop! Jacob and Evie Fry are twins. How awesome is that?
Speak of the devil. Fire up your cameras, Bex.
I've got a picture. ETA on the payload.
Sending it now.
A lot to sift through. I'm gonna get the initiates on it ASAP.
You look weird with a weapon.
Let's plant a little bug and see what we can see.
Got something.
Isabelle Ardant has a meeting here in a few hours. Doesn't say with who.
Doesn't say with.
Hey, look, today's date, the 30th, 2015.
Muggins here to find out.
Hold on. The mission was to find data to locate a piece of Eden in London.
We did.
And now, I am eager to try this new kit.
Is that Sean or Rebecca?
I don't like it when those two go off book like this. Well, all we can do is take a deep breath and move forward. You'll be searching for the piece of Eden through the lives of Jacob and Evie Fry. Twin assassins who operated in Victorian London. Your first set of genetic memories are downloaded. Good luck.
Brother George, it is as I feared. London has fallen. Thrice I have written to you begging your aid. Thrice you've responded with silence. And yet I write again. So desperate my need, so few my options. I need you. London needs you. You would say it is too great of a task, or that it is not yet time to strike. Patience, you would counsel. But whilst you wait, the Templars consolidate their power. They have chosen a Grand Master so ruthless, so thorough, one might think Reginald Birch himself had returned. His name is Crawford Starrick, and he intends to rule the world. There is no aspect of society he does not control. No industry that escapes his grim touch. By day, it is corrupt merchants and venal politicians who hold court. Come night, a vicious street gang known as the Blighters strikes terror in the hearts of all. There is no business untainted by his poison, no person unexploited, be it by duplicity or force. Our enemy has designs on the highest office of them all. And so, as you look inward, and dare I say it, afraid, Crawford Starrick's ambition is fixed on the beyond, to kingdoms and continents as yet unconquered, though not for long, for he knows. As I have warned you time and time again, whosoever controls London controls the world.
So dang, Sean, what's his last name, and Rebecca Crane looks super old now. 1868, London.
The iron ship's from here. The Templar running things is Rupert Ferris and our target one. Target two is Sir David Brewster, who's got his hands on a bauble that could ruin us in this wretched war.
That dude Jacob looks handsome. Swag. That chick Evelyn looks hot. Evelyn.
All right. My mistake. Ladies and gentlemen, the unstoppable.
Oh, never mind. There they are.
See them nightly at Covent Garden.
George, honestly, I've studied the plans of the laboratory and have every route covered.
And I've got all I need. Right here. I'll extend your regards to Ferris.
Chat later, George. We've a train to catch.
Jacob! Evie! May the greed guide you, you vagrants!
Poor man. More afraid than ever. Years have not been kind.
Evie Fry, where do you get it from?
The same place as you, Jacob.
Send me some laudanum for my head.
Coming right up.
Locate and assassinate Rupert Ferris. So let's see. This menu looks a lot like Assassin's Creed 2 and Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. And Evie Ferris looks... I'm just gonna say hot. Jacob looks really cool looking. I like how they look so far. The London 1868 looks really cool. So 3 years after Lincoln was assassinated and the Civil War ended, during the middle of the Industrial Revolution. So, like, almost 70 years later after Assassin's Creed Unity being the French Revolution. So now there's trains and all this stuff going on, London, England, Victorian era. We got, let's see. I look really cool right now. I love how they actually get out the lips to resemble a character now, finally. Like, when they talk, their lip movement matches. I like the graphics, they look amazing. I also like Assassin's Creed games, like the third one, that took place in the modern era, especially how in the third one you could take a silenced pistol and your hidden blade as Desmond Miles and attack Abstergo home base and go to Brazil and all those places. I really loved that about Assassin's Creed 3. This kid, it's a child laborer. So it's like Assassin's Creed Unity, how you can free run up or down. Character looks like any other dude with that hat on, what, I don't know what style that is, but that British looking hat, scraggly coat, scraggly boots and pants, and then a beefed up arm being the hidden blade.
Locked.
What do you think you're doing?
No one goes in or out, unless there's a problem.
I hold the machines. That door opens, and I have my route to Ferris.
So you can sneak just like in Assassin's Creed Unity. Except you put your hood up and take your hat off in this one. Which I actually don't really like earlier when he gets a top hat. It just doesn't look as good. But right now with this hat, I like how it looks. And also, you can free run up down like Unity. And also, rather than having to hold LT or press LT to get into crouch mode, you can just press A to get into crouch mode, so much quicker and easier. No need to hold anything, just press it. And you can throw your knife like in AC3, AC2, or AC Brotherhood, AC2, and Revelations, you could throw a knife. Here you can also. Ferris Bueller.
What's all this? Which one of you is responsible?
Wasn't us?
Who are you?
The sanitary inspector. This man is dead.
The dead man ran along home. I'll teach you how to fake your mercy.
Okay, I kind of like this attack already. Bitch. Good, you can carry bodies once again. And you can throw them, just like before. That's what Unity was missing. You can go stealthy, you can get into cover and all that. Or you can go in stealth mode, and you can...
Oh, someone stop that thief!
do all that, but you cannot move bodies. Here you can move bodies, get in crouch mode, all that good stuff. Here you don't hold A to get in cover, you just press up against it, like in other games such as Metal Gear Solid. I wonder if you can, you have to still be able to loot. My main gripe for this game was the combat. It looked too much like Batman Arkham Origins, which, like I said, I like, but for Batman, not for Assassin's Creed. But so far, I love the combat. It's just so fun. I just want to stay in this outfit the whole game. I don't want the top hat, don't want the longer coat, don't want the fancier coat or fancier pants. I just want this thug looking outfit. I love this music too.
Time to head for higher ground.
Look at all the smoke. There, around this time period, a bunch of smoke and steam factories and all this used to would come up. So now look how much dirtier the world is going to be than cleaner world. I mean, the street's still dirty, but at least the air is clean. Now this air is getting polluted as well. And also, it's kind of funny, in history class, we're learning about the 1800s era and all that, so this game fits in nicely with that. Detection. Enemies who can see you will become suspicious. If you stay in their line of sight, so white. If you stay in their line of sight, they will become aggressive and attack you. Yellow. Move behind, move, yellow, and then red's detected. Move behind cover to lose enemies. They will investigate your last known position. So like Splinter Cell or Unity.
Right there!
Go, bro! Bitch. Yeah, he did kick the bucket. Oh, this game. This is fun. Can't climb with those spikes. In my opinion, he looks better with the hood on, with the top hat versus hood. But with this hat, he looks cool either way. Top hat better with the hood on. This way, cool hood or this hat, but cooler with this hat. Either way, though, it's good, but with this hat, it's better, in my opinion.
Coming over there.
So Eagle Vision's like the older ones, not like Unity, it's like the... It's like Brotherhood, Revelations, Assassin's Creed 3, and Assassin's Creed 4. But it looks really cool now. Choo-choo train! That's what I was really excited for in this game, is the trains. Call me a child, but I was excited for trains in the set, in the franchise. Ooh, nice, they have double assassinations back. Like in 4 and 3. That's real nice. Then your health regenerates like it did in 3 and 4. They got little kids back too. Because child labor was a big part in this time period, so it makes sense to have kids back in the game. You can see it's like the other fighting games where they have combos, like Batman, for instance. They have combo streaks like this, and they have nice cinematics for finishers, also like they did in Assassin's Creed 3. They had nice slow-mo, AC4 nice slow-mo, here they have nice cinematic. Lifts, or sneaking, it makes it harder to detect and allows you to move faster. The stealth ring shows enemies above and below you. From behind cover, hold X to aim, then press RT to throw knives. That's interesting, you move faster while stealth rather than not. You can see enemies through walls.
Get you off the brandy. I do like some good discussion with my afternoon pick.
Blimey! Yeah, you can see enemies through walls like you could in 4 and Unity. You just press it while moving like Unity to see through walls and all that, rather than having to hold it like in previous games and having to stand still while holding it or slightly moving while holding it.
Someone take care of me.
Bitch.
Abigail Smith, Jasper.
That kid sounds like Duck from The Walking Dead.
No crying. Get to work. Your families are counting on you.
Mr. Ferris, sir.
The brute Ferris assassinate.
Should be taken to be bandaged by the apothecary.
Fine. But dock his wages.
Yes, sir.
Shall we arrive at a final price, Mr. Ferris?
Beach, let's go balls to the wall. Looks like everyone you can loot now. Maybe in the beginning I just wanted you to get used to the game before it started letting you loot people. I love this music, though. Look at the little kids working. Oh man, this music I love. That's probably one of my favorite parts right now, with just the music. That's one thing Ubisoft is real good at, picking good music. That kid just witnessed murder. Probably gonna have some trauma. Bitch, let's go. Looks like our first brute.
He's gonna stay!
suppers are dear to me. Do let me know if there's anything else I can do.
Western Pacha
is done.
Oh? What did you accomplish, boy?
A bolt loosened in Starek's machine. A large bolt. But not enough.
Your Grandmaster will fall.
You assassins can circle London to your heart's content. The mechanism we have built has been going strong for 100 years and will run 1,000 more. It is the very city itself.
We will take London from your hands.
From Croydon? You lurk in the shadows like a coward. I doubt it.
We seem to have made an unscheduled stop.
Bad.
Maybe next time I'll walk.
Sequence 1, a spanner in the works, completed. 1,000 euros, I'm guessing that is. 2,000 XP, belts, initiate belt. Hope you guys enjoyed, and we'll continue next time.